time for the members of Workers' Defense Project. These are stories that many of us here, many workers here, have gone through. But you see how the story ended? That's the story that we're writing together. And it inspires me that we're doing this together. So I want to give you all an update on where we are in that tug of war, in that campaign, in this campaign to win an agreement with Gables Residential. We've continued to meet with them. They've been productive meetings. They've said they want to collaborate with us back in Austin. We want them to collaborate with us here in Dallas too. And we're here to show them that. So that's why we're here, because this campaign isn't only going to happen in backdoor meetings. This is about us. This is about community. This is about our cousins, our brothers, our sisters. And we should all be involved in this fight. And I thank you for being in this fight. So next up, I want to introduce a person who's quickly becoming a friend of Workers' Defense Project, of the labor community, here to take us to church, Reverend J.D. Allen.
Hey.
How you doing today? I'll tell you what, I'm like just about anybody else. I like to come to the park on a summer day, meet friends, make new friends, and have a good time. How about you?
Yeah!
But on another note, I'm a little distressed at the reason we have to gather today. I think it's a tragedy because the fact that we're gathering signifies that once again, hardworking people are being exploited and oppressed here in our hometown, here in Dallas, Texas. We know that they're suffering from unsafe working conditions and from an all too common phenomenon known as wage theft. I know you've been suffering this. I know our friends here with the Workers' Defense Project have been suffering this. It's time for that to stop. We went to Gables yesterday and delivered a petition. We gather here today because we want to remind Gables of what their contractors have apparently forgotten or are flat out ignoring. That all people, all women and men, are created in the image of God and deserve the utmost respect. They are not assets to be utilized for profits. They are human beings who are partners in our lives together. The fact that workers have to go to work sites and have conditions that are more unsafe because of safety violations is unacceptable. The fact that workers go onto work sites wondering and worrying if they will return home to their families healthy and whole and able to support their families the next day is a travesty. The fact that the reality of injuries and the potentiality of injuries on work sites is treated as nothing more than collateral damage in the war for ever-increasing profits is flat-on immoral. Yes. We are here to say no to that and yes to justice.
Yes.
Respecting the dignity, respecting the image of God in our neighbor demands that fair wages be paid, that full compensation be provided for the work that workers put in to Gables work sites to build their luxury communities. To hear that workers are working 50 to 60 hours a week and not seeing one penny of overtime pay is ridiculous. It's unacceptable.
It should be illegal.
To know that workers on Gables work sites have suffered wage theft to the tune of over $140,000 is another note of immorality that we must put a stop to. The epistle of James in the New Testament and Christian scriptures calls out those who keep back the wages of their workers. It calls them out. It says those wages cry out, and that the cries of the workers have reached the ears of the Lord. If you're here today and you're calling on Gables, you're crying out because you're a worker, or you're crying out because you support the workers. You can know those cries have reached the ears of the Lord. God is not deaf. God is not plugging God's ears. God is not turning God's back. God is on our side.
Yeah.
put that another way. Let me put that another way. We are on God's side. Because God has heard the cries of the workers. So we call out to Gables. They've become partners in Austin. Here in Dallas, we want to tell them it's not too late. Those cries have reached the ears of the Lord, but you can become partners with the workers today. Yeah. Gables has the voice and the power to hold accountable the contractors on their work sites, to hold accountable all employers on their work sites, to make sure conditions are safe, pay is fair, and pay is just. So we call on Gables to be that partner with the workers here today, with the workers on all their work sites throughout the state of Texas, especially here in Dallas, to be a partner in reconciliation with your workers. Take their hand. Hold it together. Be partners. Not managers, not profiteers, but partners. Because we can transform the tragedy that takes place on Gables work sites into a joyous celebration of beloved community today. What do you say?
Yeah. Amen.
Let me say that one more time. We can transform the tragedy on Gables work sites into a celebration of beloved community. That's exactly what we're doing today. Thank you, JD. So, is our Walmart in the house?
Yes!
All right, our Walmart has been shaking things up here in Dallas. Just last week, 26 associates went on strike. And we're lucky, we're honored to have one of those associates here with us today. Let's give it up for Q. Together, all Walmart, Workers Defense Project, all of the organizations represented here, this fight is ours, together. Next up, I'd like to introduce Bonnie Mathias, Vice President of the Communication Workers of America, Local 6215. Bonnie.
All right, man, everybody's excited. This is an awesome crowd, I gotta tell you. My name is Bonnie Mathias. I'm an officer, as he said, at Communication Workers of America, Local 6215. I'm also a community activist, a top member, and a caring citizen. Gables Residential is not being held accountable for injuries occurring on their job sites. People are working 50 to 60 hours a week, not receiving wages for all the time they spend on the job sites. That's not fair, is it?
No!
You know, Gables Residential has over 50 properties already in the state of Texas. And there's more to come. Right here in North Texas, I'm sure. You know, we have a building boom going on. Thousands of workers across the United States have reported illegal working conditions and wage theft. This company should be held accountable for their subcontractors. They hired them. They should be held accountable.
Yeah!
This developer must ensure that their subcontractors supply clean, adequate water, safety equipment, safety training, and workers' compensation benefits if you're injured on the job. Yeah! On this Father's Day, we should remember many of these workers have families. Their fathers. Those families depend on them to come home safe every day with a paycheck that will support their families. We are calling on Gables to do the right thing. Join with Workers Defense Project, other community organizations that are standing with them to ensure the safety of our workers and to ensure that they get a fair day's pay for their work. Thank you.
When I say build it, you say better. Build it.
Better.
Build it.
Better.
All right. Next up, I'd like to introduce Frederico Letman. Frederico. Let's give it up.
Thank you, everybody. Happy Father's Day. I'm a long-term resident of Gables, and you know, they market themselves as luxury, first-class organization, and the properties, I thank you guys, because my family shares. I have two kids, and they share in the benefit of your hard work, so I want to thank you. Give yourself a hand for that. I think when we look at the situation, I mean, it's unfair that anybody goes to work. I'm in banking. I'm in the end that supplies the money to build these projects. And, you know, when we look at these deals, it's, hey, we got to make sure people are being taken care of. It's unfair if you go to work, you work hard. I believe in a hard day's work. I'm a veteran. I spent 8 years in the military, and I lived on a ship for about 4 or 5 years. To all the veterans, and you know, when you get out there, it's every day, is you don't know if you're going to come home. Because if you don't have the right equipment, you don't have the right safety gear, you don't have the right people, the right support, the right rest, the right water, the things that you need, the basics. You know, I'm here to support you guys as a resident, as a long-term resident, to say that I support Gables hiring the right people, doing the right thing, and making sure you guys are safe, making sure you're getting paid. It's not fair, and we got to get this.
So let's all put our hands
Thank you for having me come and be a part of this, and I really appreciate you guys, and I just want to say thank you.
Bravo!
It's about partnership, right? Residents, workers, community members, Gables itself, right? We're on a long road to ensure their partnership, and that's why we're here. That's why we're here. They have yet to know all of the outrage, all of the pain, and all of the passion that we have as a community for the workers on their sites. So that's why we're here. It's not over yet. It may not be over soon, but we'll get there. We'll get them to partner with us. Listo para la marcha, Modesto.
Listo.
Nosotros los miembros del proyecto de defensa laboral sabemos lo que es el abuso, sabemos lo que es ser no pagado después de un duro día de trabajo, pero hay trabajo, cosas que nos une, y es que estamos cansados de tanto abuso, y es por eso alzamos la voz para exigir justicia. Tenemos con nosotros a Julio González y su papá Roberto. Se fracturaron las dos manos en el sitio de Gable McKinney, no muy lejos de aquí. También es trabajador de la construcción. Un fuerte aplauso para Julio.
We members of Workers Defense Project know what abuse is. We know what it's like not to get paid after a long day's work. But there's something else that unites us and joins us together. And that's that we're raising our voices for justice. So we were in touch. We've been in touch, and we've been working with a construction worker, a gentleman named Julio González. His father, Roberto González, is a cement mason, and he fractured both his hands at the Gables McKinney site, which is just down the road, just down McKinney right here. Now, I think it should come as no surprise that Roberto González, we invited him to come, we invited him to join us here, but he couldn't, because just this last week, he's had 3 surgeries on his hands. He got injured on April 3rd. What day is it today? June 14th. To this day, he is suffering the consequences of his injury. So we honor Julio González. He couldn't make it here today because of work. He's out working, providing for his family. We honor the story of Roberto González, who as well wishes he could come here. I just spoke to him yesterday. He wishes he could be here, but his health just doesn't permit it. So let's take about 30 seconds, a moment of silence. Let's honor the workers, the families who couldn't be here today, who are going through these violations. Thank you.
¿Listos para la marcha? ¡Sí! Gables Dallas nos va a escuchar. ¿Listos?
¡Sí!
Y'all ready to march?
¡Sí!
We're going to tell Gables, Uptown, and the whole city of Dallas that it's time to...
¡Sí!
It's time to...
¡Sí!
¿Sabía usted que Gables tiene 13 edificios aquí en Dallas? Y que dos más se están construyendo, vamos a marchar en uno de ellos.
Did you know that Gables has 13 properties here in Dallas? Well, we're going to march to one of those properties right now and deliver a letter, explain to them what we want, explaining to them that we want safe jobs and dignified wages for all the workers on their sites. Y'all ready? All right, so our members, Manuel Rodriguez and his compañero have already stepped off.